Take your shoes off, you need to.
The brightest, the way you're the shining, the bling like me, you're the
and I go different places. I've seen many faces that cannot replace you. But you wanna gain many blessings. Girl, you want my life, you're the finest. Yeah, now you be the finest thing I've seen. You're the brightest. The way you the shine in the bling like me. You're the highest. When it comes to everything, you're the lead. My princess, my only one lover.
Some more. The only woman I need, baby, there's no better lover for me. tell me you will stay tonight. Nobody can love you better. I'll be your groupie, you're my star and the queen of my area. If you tell me you will stay tonight, nobody can love you better. If you want me to my mama, oh baby, why buy me low? They call me like say I did Chris. I'm giving you too much. Make me say
Jama, thank you for bringing this girl in my life.
And when you need me, girl, you know, say me go always on time.
And girl, you need to know, for you, me go the extra mile.
And when the haters try to dish, you don't say nothing, just smile.
Why? Late nights, blackberry bold. Now, baby, love, I am the one you should be holding. Late nights, blackberry bold. With every message, girl, my heart is unfolding.
If you tell me you will stay.
Let's begin singing hymn number 60, Find Us Together.
Thank you.
the introduction to our service tells us the hallmarks of Christian marriage. And as we hear these words in church this afternoon, we think of this couple on their birthday and pray for them, and also for ourselves and for those we love. In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Agboola and Florence, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body and mind, as Christ is united with his bride. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God, and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honor. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, in the sight of Almighty God. Agboola and Florence are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows, and in token of this, they will give and receive their names. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it down. Agboola, Florence, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and who knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows the reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it. Agboola, will you take Florence to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Florence, will you take Agboola to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And please, would everybody answer with the words, "We will." Would you, the families and friends of Florence and Agboola, support and uphold them today in their marriage and in all the years to come? A prayer for them both. God, our Father, from the beginning, you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon these, your children, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigning.
Our reading today is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, from verse 1 to verse 8. The gift of love. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy god or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. This is the end of our reading.
And now we come to the very special part of our service where Florence and Agboola are going to make their vows to one another. Would you please stand down for the vows? Who is this woman to be married to this man? In the presence